I'm Joey Angel.
I'm Vivian Chen.
I'm Ronnie Peterson.
I'm Trevor Norton.
Hi, I'm Evan Forenberger. And are you a student who lives on a tight budget? Somebody that doesn't have a lot of free money to spend? With rent, groceries, and college tuition, the amount of money we have each month doesn't feel like enough to get the necessities we need, like furniture, basic school supplies, and new clothes. Well, at Sparky's Buyback, we wanted to offer a service to the student body that provides these items at a cost that no other company can match. Our goal was to create a company with the understanding that providing is more important than profits, and this idea is exemplified by all of our suppliers and consumers being students.
Our service is a thrift shop that is on campus where you can sell and donate your items back to the store. You can buy items for a fair price from the thrift store. If you're a WPK business student, you can earn business experience by working in the store in a managerial position, and you can save money and make money while not hurting your wallet. So throughout your time at ASU, you can keep your wallet in a good position by keeping the cycle of selling slash donating your items back to the store and buying used items at a good price from the store.
We're pleased to work with Mr. Sean Kroll from Assistance League East Valley, which is a nonprofit organization that relies on thrift shop as its primary source of income. Mr. Sean Kroll is also an experienced businessman of many years, and he has provided us with useful advice on areas such as more specific positioning to really distinguish ourselves in the market of thrift shops, more thorough expense and revenue to consider some of the shop expenses that we wouldn't have considered before, logistical considerations in the store layout, and finally, employees. We will now elaborate on the multiple areas of our business model, beginning with competitors. First of all, we have other thrift shops to compete with, such as Salvation Army and Habitat for Humanity, but we distinguish ourselves in the way that we take furnitures and buy them, whereas they only take furnitures for donation, so students can make a small amount of money while selling them. We also compete with students who want to donate for nonprofit organizations rather than selling them to us, but we can create incentives for them to donate specific items for us that will benefit them in the long run as well. And finally, we have actual furniture and clothing stores to compete with as well, but we're better because we're cheaper. Our first strategy is to market through the ASU network. Our slogan is by students, for students, which means that we'll have more practical items for the students that are provided by students, because students' items are things that students truly need. It's also student run, so it benefits both the consumers who can buy it at a cheaper price and the employees who can get practical experience.
Now imagine this, you're a first year student living in the dorms and you have a flight home in 1 week. Okay, it's the end of the semester and you have a bunch of stuff piled up throughout the year. Now, you don't know what to do with that. You can either put it on Craigslist or you can go to another Goodwill and drop it off. But rather, instead of having to walk and do all the timely aspects of Craigslist and such, things such as that, you can go down to your residential hall and drop it off. What makes us unique is Sparky's Buyback Residential Drop-Off. This allows students to go no farther than the residential hall to drop off items that they don't need or don't want. This allows them to just leave it there, and we take it, we pick it up, and bring it back to the store. This makes it easy, simple, and makes the whole process a lot better for us.
Which brings us to our next competitive advantage, geographical proximity. Students do not need to go out of their way to donate their items or buy items. It's located on campus, so it's really convenient for students, and it's truly part of the Sun Devil community. We also hope to collaborate with the Fulton School of Engineering to have computer science majors develop an app for us, which will provide a real-time update with pictures and price of our signature items, which are the furnitures that are more expensive than other items, for students in the season of trying to rent an apartment and fill them up with furniture. They can place a 24-hour order on it and check on the store.
When looking at the demographics of Tempe, we see that young adults are the majority by far. Also, we see that Phoenix is the second largest growing city in America. That means that we have a huge pool of people to work with, and they're right in our range of young adults we want to be selling our items to and receiving items from. Also, we look at our target audience here on campus. There are 42,477 students enrolled at Tempe alone. That means that the pool of students that we'll be working with is huge. That means we can have a lot of we can get a lot of sales and we can get a lot of items to sell.
So some problems that we thought we might encounter as being a business is theft and security. So to combat these issues, for theft, we'll have a bag check, so every customer will check their bag with the cashier when they enter, and then they can get their bag back and check it when they leave. And then for security, we'll have a 24-hour alarm system that will notify any managers of unwanted break-ins, and we'll also have a pull-down security girl to help prevent those unwanted break-ins.
All right, and I know what you're thinking. Joey, this is the greatest idea I've ever heard, and I'm here to tell you that this greatest idea you've ever heard is also very feasible as well. So first, I'm going to cover the expenses. So we are always going to have about 2 employees working per hour. We're always going to be open about 8 hours per day. And then we're going to be open about 150 days a year, which is about how long school is open as well. So, you know, to make sure that the students can also actually work as well. So we're always open when the school's open. And then projected first year expenses as well. So that's going to be stuff that's, you know, stuff that will be recurring, like credit card payments or fees or, you know, just anything involving that we're going to have to consistently pay, as well as things that's just a one-time payment, like security cameras or fixtures, stuff like that as well. So we're estimating that the employees, that's going to cost about $30,000. And then the other stuff, the first-year expense is going to be about $32,000. And then we have the customers. So customers play a really big role in our business because they're going to be donating stuff, and we're also going to be receiving products that they donated as well. And so we're estimating that there's about 15,000 students on campus, and chances are if you're a full-time student and you're not on campus, you're really close to campus as well. And so we're estimating the participation of those people is going to be about 20%. Usually people donate in bulk as well, so that will be about 6 items per person. And then we're also going to have about a turnover rate estimated of about 67%. So the sales breakdown that you typically see in the thrift store is about 60% of the sales goes to clothes, 35% goes to miscellaneous items, and only about 5% goes to furniture. And then we have our sales as well. So how are we actually going to be making money, right? So we have clothes. Clothes are going to be donated. Miscellaneous items are going to be donated. Both of those are low-cost items, right? And so we're not going to be paying for those necessarily. We're expecting those to be donated. But furniture, on the other hand, since that's a big-ticket item, that's going to be donated, and we're going to buy it back for about $15, profit margin of 50%. Furniture is going to sell for about $30. We're estimating miscellaneous items, most of them are going to sell for about $8, and most clothes are typically sold for under $5, so we're estimating it's going to sell for about $4. And so we're estimating our total revenue for the first year is going to be about $80,000, total expenses about $76,000, and so profit about $4,000 our first year.
In conclusion, we at Sparky's Buyback believe that we have found a great niche that will have repeated revenue and can be successful. Anybody can look at our business plan and think, how come I didn't think of that? It is incredibly simple, but it can be effective. In all, as a group, we believe that while we started Sparky's Buyback as a project, we have stumbled upon an ingenious idea that should be on every campus across the nation, starting here at ASU. Thank you for your time, and we hope you recognize the potential for this company.
Are there any questions?